Hello and welcome to Java9s.com. I'm Srinivas. In this session, I'm going to talk about the OGNL and ValueStack concepts. It is important to understand these concepts to work with Struts2. Coming to the agenda part, first I will give an introduction about the OGNL and its role in Struts2 Framework, and then I'll give a detailed explanation about the ValueStack. So let's talk about the OGNL. It is called the Object Graph Navigation Language, and now just don't relate it to the some Facebook related search. These are not related. So OGNL handles two important things in Struts 2. One is the type conversion, that is the conversion of values that are entered into the form to the type that are there in the bean. And then it also offers the expression language to access the values inside the beans. So there are two parts into it. And not only that, OGNL can also invoke some methods onto the Java classes. So it is more powerful than what we think as an accessible expression language to the Java beans. And it was integrated when Struts2 got integrated with WebWorks. So now this is about a small introduction to the OGNL, and let's take a simple example of how OGNL works in terms of request handling, or you know, a simple flow of Struts2. Let us take an example of having a form and storing the values into a Java bean, and then accessing those values to show the response. So I have this flow, and in this flow, the OGNL helps to, first step of OGNL comes in terms of type conversion, that is the parameters that are coming from the request are actually in the form of string, and these values have to be stored on the Java types, like they can be primitive types or they can be custom data types. So the type conversion part of the OGNL takes care of converting these string to the respective Java data types that are there on the bean. So this bean is actually referred on the value stack. And then again, after that, the OGNL has much more to offer than the type conversion. That is, it offers the form tag so that you can pinpoint what form value has to be set into what property of a Java bean. So OGNL can is offering a lot of form tags, and then it also offers some UI related tags to iterate through the collections and then iterate through arrays and display different types of elements, something like that. So OGNL not only converts the form values to the Java types, it also helps to convert the Java type to the string type when the response is being sent. So OGNL takes care of the complete conversion criteria here. And then to discuss about the OGNL and value stack, the complete OGNL concept, I have divided these concepts into three areas. One is value stack, the second one is the type conversion part, and finally, to complete that, we have to also talk about the expressions and tags, that is form tags, UI tags, etc. So in this part, I will concentrate on value stack. So let us discuss the concept of value stack with an example here. So take a user who is trying to access the Struts2 application, and he sends a request by filling a form. And to cater to that request, we need an action object, and say we need also need a Java bean to store the form values. So the action object and also your model objects, whatever it is, a Java bean, are actually stored on the are referred by the value stack. Please remember that they are referred by the value stack object. Not only that, a request will also have access to the platform level objects, like, you know, your request attribute map, session attributes, and also your application attributes. So if you look at the value stack, each and every request will have its own value stack in an Struts application. So if you look at different requests, each and every request will have its own path of value stack. You might ask me, why did you show application attribute as a separate object for value stack? It is actually a common object just to show you that each and every value stack will have a reference to application attribute. I've just mentioned it as different objects. So when it comes to value stack, please remember that this value stack is the thread local object for each request. That means the value stack that is created for a particular request will not have any interference with the other value stack that is created for a different request. So they are local to a particular thread. So that's what we call it, thread local. And to discuss much detail about the value stack, it has basically two important parts. That is the object stack, and the second one is the context map. So coming to the object stack, it is actually a stack where the objects are piled based on the entry level, like who comes first will stay there. So objects will be stored on the index based. So because it's a stack, so we can refer the objects using index. So object 1, object 2, object 3, object 4, something like that. Like, you know, action object might come first, then whatever the objects that it might be referring will be coming later on the top of the stack. So please remember that object stack is created for the request. Object stack is the one which holds the objects which are created for the request. And the second one is the context map, which actually holds the maps that are related to the platform. Say the context map has the request parameters object, which has all the parameters that are sent through the HTTP protocol. That means you'll be able to access the form values that you have entered using this map. And next one is the request attributes. You might have saved some object into the request attribute to access them on the response of the page. So you can access that object as well using context map. And not only that, you will be able to access the session attributes and the application attributes as well. And there's one more part in this, something called app attribute map, which using which you will be able to access all the three attribute maps. That means if you're not sure in which scope the object is being stored, you can ask the attribute map to search for you so that it can search through the request. Then it goes to search in the session and application attribute, and in whichever scope it finds the object, it returns that object. So this is about the value stack and its two important parts. So please remember that object stack is the place where the objects that are created to cater to the request are stored, and the context map is the place where the maps that are related to the platform are there. So both the ways, value stack will have the full details of objects that are created, and the details that are needed for the response are also part of the context map. So it is the complete playground of a particular request for the Struts2 framework. And please remember that OGNL is an expression language, and it is used to access the objects that are part of the value stack here. And value stack is the work of the Struts2 framework. So Struts2 framework has opened up value stack ground for the open graph navigation language to be able to access the objects with ease. So there's a lot of hard work that has been put into the Struts2 framework to integrate OGNL by, you know, the Struts2 developers community to make it more and more simple and powerful. So this is about value stack. Now let us see how we can access the values from the value stack using the OGNL expression language. So I'm just going to give a simple high level tags overview. So if you look at accessing the objects that are there in the stack, you can use the index and the name of the property to access that. Basically 99% of the time we will never use this kind of syntax because we don't know in what index an object is present. So it is better to go ahead to use the object name or attribute name to access that object, particular object. But just to tell you that basically the objects are stored as part of an stack which can be accessed with using an index. I'm just showing you this particular syntax, but most of the time we don't use this kind of syntax. Then coming to accessing the context map, that is the second part. To access the parameters, you can use hash parameters dot count of zero. You can see that I have used an array syntax for the count. That means that whenever you request for parameters from the request parameters object, it is going to return you an array. So you have to be very specific about which indexed parameter do you need. So that's why I have mentioned here as an index here. And coming to accessing the request attribute, you have to use hash request, and you can use the bean name and the property name as such. And you have two other forms which use the single inverted commas and the double quotes as well. So you can use any of the syntax you wish to. And it's the same way you can go ahead to talk to the session attributes and also the application attributes. And the final part in this is using the attribute search. You can use hash attr to talk to attribute map, which can help you search through the request, session and attribute, application attributes. And you don't have to remember in which scope it is. It will help you to search through all the scopes and gives you the values whichever it finds in the first place. And please remember that all the expressions now I have mentioned here should be part of the value attribute in a property tag. They are not independent tags, as I have mentioned. Just don't think that we can print the output just like that. They have to be part of the property tag, something like this, which I have mentioned here. So in the next session, I'm going to talk about the type conversions and what are the different types of type converters that are available. And the third part, I'll also talk about the expression tags that are there for the forms and UIs. I'll also give some better examples in the next session when I talk about the type conversion. So that's all for this session about the OGNL and value stack. Please give your feedback as comments and visit java9s.com for more videos. You can follow me on Twitter at java9s, and you can also like my page on Facebook, which is with the java9s. So that's all for this session. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.